when I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart go deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart go deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. When I pray, I feel my soul go deeper, my soul go deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my soul go deeper, my soul go deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. When I pray, I feel my love go deeper, my love go deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my love go deeper, my love go deeper into my God. Right here, right now, right where I am, I pray. Right here, right where I am, I pray. When I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart go deeper into my God. When I pray, I feel my heart go deeper, my heart go deeper into my God.
Breathing out joy. God's in his heaven, and everything's right in his world. Nature rejoice, yes, and the birds still dance, singing with elation. Sweetness is filling the air. Joy overflowing, just knowing that God is still there. Nature rejoice, yes, and the birds still dance. Sweetness is filling the air, joy overflowing, just knowing that God is still there. Lord of all creation, take my life and give me the freedom to mount up with eagles on high. Whisper my devotion, Father, the new day that breaks. God's in his heaven, and everything's right in his world. Peace in my soul, yes, and the birds still.
There's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. There's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. No religion to. Imagine all the people I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of men. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. Ooh, you may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one.
Good morning. Welcome to Unity Center of Cedar Rapids, January 10th, 2021 service. We hope you know that you are held in the highest esteem, that you are deeply appreciated and loved. My name's Nina Swanson. I'm the music director at Unity. We'd like to welcome Joe Wietrich today as our special guest musician. I hope you are filled with the joyous spirit of his music. And we hope this whole service is uplifting to you, a time of reflection and renewal. Let's all take a deep breath. Center ourselves in the divine presence as we sing together our opening hymn for the month of January, appropriately entitled, Let's Begin.
Let's begin from this moment. Let's begin now. From within, feel excitement to begin now, to grow as we follow the thread of life, sharing love with the bread of life, making all things new. Let's begin from this moment. Let's begin now. From within, feel excitement to begin now. Let's begin ever growing. Let's begin ever knowing. Let's begin.
Good morning and welcome. This is a spiritual community grounded in faith, growing in love, and grateful for all the ways that Spirit moves in and through it and in and through all of its members and friends. We are so happy that you're with us today, and certainly we hope that this service today blesses you in some way and invites you to open yourself ever more fully to the presence of God within you that expresses in you, through you, as you. Our invocation has proven to be very grounding for me this week. And so I invite you to affirm it with me with intention, together. There is only one presence and one power in my life and in the universe, God, the good, omnipotent. There is only one presence and one power in my life and in the universe, God, the good, omnipotent. And so it is. Amen.
Hi, everyone. I'm glad that you're here today. My name is Laura Mead, and I'm happy to be here with you, too. I have just a few announcements before we get started. The first one is that Jan Griffith and Susan Liddell, who are both members of the prayer team and our licensed Unity leaders, are both standing by after the service to pray with you. If you'd like to pray with them too, you can reach by calling 319-382-2009 immediately after the service. And I encourage you to take advantage of their calming presence, especially after the events of this week. You'll be amazed at how much better you feel after praying with somebody. So 319-382-2009. The second announcement is that we'll be having coffee hour after the service today, and that's on Zoom, and there are a few ways that you can get that Zoom link. The first is by emailing Reverend Debra at minister@unitycr.org. The second is if you're on Facebook right now, the link should be in the chat box. And the third way is to check your e-news, because there is a link there as well. The third announcement is this Tuesday at 6:30, Reverend Debra will be hosting Truth Topic Tuesday. And the topic of discussion this time is the nature of humankind. This isn't a class, but it's just a discussion, a conversation. And you'll find the registration information in the e-news, or you can email Reverend Debra for more information. The last announcement is to mark your calendar for January 24th, because that is our annual meeting. And we are going to have that on Zoom this year. We want as many people to come as possibly can. We can handle it. We have a tutorial. Lisa has put together a great tutorial on how to work Zoom, so you'll find that. And you'll find all the information about the annual meeting in the e-news, and then we're also posting it onto the website. So we'll have ways that you can find out what's going on. The annual meeting we'll have elections, we'll have celebrations, we'll have talk about the budget, and we'll talk about what's going on in 2021. So I hope you'll plan to join us after the service on January 24th. Now, please join me in our statement of purpose. Unity is a positive path for spiritual living. We gather to create an experience of spirit. At Unity CR, we offer practical teachings that empower abundant and meaningful living. Meeting you right where you are, we endeavor to provide a variety of ways to support your path of spiritual living. Our mission is to provide spiritual awareness and share the wonder and joy of God's love. Today's daily word is prosperity. And the affirmation is, I claim prosperity now. When I feel tempted to wish for a more prosperous life, I remember my prosperity begins at the level of my thinking. I focus my thoughts on the many blessings already in my life, and I feel grateful. From this place of gratitude, it becomes easy to notice more and more blessings around me. This awareness helps me develop an attitude of prosperity. I tend to my thoughts of prosperity as though they are flowers in a garden. I plant them in good soil and nurture them with water and sunshine. This rich environment allows prospering ideas to take root and grow. As I nurture these ideas, I am abundantly blessed in life, love, health, and joy. And the Bible reading comes from Psalm 36, verse 8. They feast on the abundance of your house, and you give them drink from the river of your delights. Enjoy the rest of the service, and I'll see you after the service in our coffee hour.
I can change the world with my own two hands, make it a better place with my own two hands, make it a kinder place with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands. I can make peace on earth with my own two hands. I can clean up the earth with my own two hands. I can reach out to you with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands. Gonna make it a brighter place with my own two hands. Gonna make it a safer place with my own two hands. Gonna help the human race with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands, with my own two hands. I can hold you with my own two hands. I can comfort you with my own two hands, but you gotta use your own two hands, use your own, use your own two hands, use your own, use your own two hands, with our own, with our own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands.
Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday. It's Josh and Mary here, and we are just excited to talk with you this morning and thank the kids for meeting with us last week. We had an opportunity to talk about our goals for this coming year and what those would look like and some ideas about how we would go about developing a deeper faith with our higher power in God. So Josh is going to tell us a little bit more about what we're doing with the kids this week.
Yeah, so this month is all about the development of faith. So we decided to find a lesson off of the Unity site that provides some perspective. It talks about the GOAT, the greatest basketball player of all time, which is not debatable. Some people think it's debatable, but I don't think it's debatable. It's Michael Jordan. It's going to talk about his growth and development and his ability to bring from the invisible, which was his aspirations of being the greatest player, to the visible and actually becoming that. There's also a story about the mustard seed and what it looks like to have the faith of a mustard seed and what that little tiny bit of faith can grow into in our hearts and in our minds and in our lives. So we're going to ask the parents to take some time to look over those lessons and maybe discuss them with the children. There's also some good meditation and some good practice that relates it and ties it back to our Unity principles. If you guys have questions as you go over the material, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. We'd love to set up some time to chat with you if that's necessary. And then as a reminder, next Sunday is our next YFM tag up. So at 11 a.m. on the 17th, please feel free to join us. We'll talk about the progress we're making on our goals, and we'll talk about the takeaways that we had from our lessons and what we learned about Michael Jordan and mustard seeds. Well, with that, thank you so much, and you guys have a great week. Blessings.
Jesus said in the Sermon on the Mount, "Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God." And what does it mean to be pure in heart? It means that we lay aside any anger, any sense of separation from our siblings, any sense of worry or concern, anything that stands in the way of experiencing the presence of God within us and the fullness of our divine self. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. And so, beloved, for just a few moments, lay aside those things that are concerning you. And enter into that solitude, that sacred space within your heart and mind, where you find the presence of God and experience your oneness with it. Come, beloved. The love of God that surrounds you and folds you, that love in which you are immersed is pure and unconditional. It has the power to heal anything unlike itself, to knit up the broken places within us, to bind up the schisms within our relationships. The love of God, divine love, expressing in you, through you, as you. That is the very love that you are called to express and experience in the world. You see, when we love, we see God. When we love another without fear, we see them as the very face of God itself. God's vision for this world is a vision of peace and love. a world in which people trust and accept one another, a world in which we are united in a sense of purpose, working together to accomplish that which is for the good of all. Working together so that all may flourish in love. And as we hold that intention, it fills our hearts, it fills our minds, it fills our consciousness with the energy, the healing power of divine love. As we hold that vision of harmony and peace and human flourishing and divine expression, we create the space into which possibility and potential, the very energy of God, flow forth to cast that vision out in front of us. Means that we are establishing ourselves in the energy that will pull us into its expression. Blessed are the pure in heart. Blessed are they who let go of anger, who let go of exclusion, who release themselves from the grasp of hatred and fear. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. God in themselves, God expressing in their lives, and God in the face of others. And so, beloved, in these next few moments in silence and quietness, open your heart, open your mind, open your being, inviting spirit to move anything out of the way within you that impedes the divine vision of love and flourishing to be made manifest in your life, in your world, in your community, in your relationship, in all creation. In the silence, be pure in heart and open your eyes to see God. Divine love, good and gracious God, we thank you for moving within us in these past few moments of prayer. We thank you for inspiring us with a renewed vision, for opening our eyes so that we can look past appearances and see your presence in all and through all. As we are pure in heart, we see you, and we see you in all people and in all creation. And as we begin to bring our attention back to this moment, we bring with us a heart overflowing with gratitude, and we say, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And so it is, and so it shall ever be. Amen.
As times unfolded me, it has revealed to me, life's nothing less than sublime. With every thought I make, every last breath I take, may I be gracious and kind. Love, I invite you to open up this heart of mine. Love, cover me like any darkness. Love, cover me, right every wrong. Cause me to see love over hatred. Guide me to be faithful and strong. Love, cover me. Love, cover me. Kindness, wash over me, make me a symphony, play every note you can find. Make me reverberate, gently deactivate, slowly flow out of my mind. Find me a melody, dance and let my anthem be. Love, cover me, light any darkness. Love, cover me, right every wrong. Cause me to see love over hatred. Guide me to be faithful and strong. Love, cover me. Love, cover me. Love, 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 love. I invite you to open up this heart of mine. Love, cover me, light any darkness. Love, cover me, right every wrong. Cause me to see love over hatred. Guide me to be faithful and strong. Love, cover me. Love, cover me. Love, cover me. Love, cover me. Love, cover me.
During the span of my lifetime, I have, of course, lived through many historical events, important ones. But there are several that are imprinted on my memory forever. The first is the assassination of John F. Kennedy. And I'm not quite certain if this is an authentic memory, or rather one that I absorbed as I felt the anxiety, the fear, the shock, the worry, the concern of my family. But I have a vague recollection of sitting on the linoleum rug in my grandparents' living room, watching the events unfold on their black and white Philco television. I have greater clarity of memory around the assassination of Martin Luther King and that of Robert Kennedy, the moonwalk, the beginning and ending of a couple of wars, the assassination attempt on Ronald Reagan, the murder of John Lennon, and of course 9/11. But January 6, 2021 is another historical event that is imprinted on my memory. As I watched this group of angry people, many with an intention to do harm, marauding through the nation's Capitol building, I felt a sense of anger welling up within me. And I finally realized that my anger was mirroring the anger of those that I was watching marauding through the halls of the Capitol. And I stopped myself because I realized that that anger was doing little toward healing this moment. Certainly wasn't making me feel any better. Ruth Geary, our office administrator, reminded me this week that anger is often used to cover over pain and fear. And certainly that was true of me as this anger began to rise up within me. I was covering over my fear, my worry, my deep, deep concern, my pain. And I truly believe as well that the anger that we are witnessing on full display in our nation at this moment is covering over a deep pain and fear. Now, I'm not exactly sure where this fear is coming from where it's originating, but my suspicion is that there is a fear of a loss of something. The loss of a status quo, the loss of privilege. There's a consciousness of scarcity that's at the foundation of it as well, that if we want and intend for the flourishing of all humanity, then our flourishing is diminished in some way. Now, I'm an idealist. And I have at times been accused of being impractical and unrealistic as I have doggedly clung to the belief that there is no evil force at work in this world that is opposed to God intending to do us harm. There are people, however, out of their pain and their anger, out of their fear, who do harmful things. And I will say that my idealism is a bit shaken at this moment, but it is not broken. I do not believe that there is evil afoot in this world. I will not dehumanize these I see acting out of their fear and their pain. I will not make them into monsters, but I will say, enough is enough. Mary Shelley, the creator of the prototypical monster Frankenstein, wrote, "No one consciously chooses evil because it is evil. One only mistakes it for the happiness that one seeks." In Genesis 50:21, we find these words spoken by Joseph to his brothers who had sold him into bondage. "You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good." I will admit I've had difficulty creating a sense of understanding around that Bible verse. You did not mean it for evil, but God meant it for good. as if God set some plan in motion that created an experience of pain and difficulty and tragedy in one's life. That flies in the face of what I know as God's nature. But rather than throw this scripture out with the bathwater, I decided to investigate it a little bit more. And if one looks at the word used for meant in this scripture, God meant it for good, in the original Hebrew, you see that the word means to regard as or to reckon as. You meant it for evil, but God regarded it as good. God reckoned it as good. For me, that shifted things, because what it helped me to see is that people do things out of their pain and their anger that are harmful. But in the midst of that difficult, painful moment, God can reckon it as good. You can call forth the good that is in it, the presence of God that is in it. And here we have a moment in our collective history where we can do just that. We can reckon it as good. January 6th in the church year is Epiphany. It is the day in which we commemorate the arrival of the wise men in Bethlehem to adore the baby Jesus that they have sought after they followed his star. The word Epiphany means revelation or the appearance of the divine. But here in this moment, on the day of Epiphany, we have had a collective epiphany as that which needs to be healed is revealed to us, but also as we hold to the truth that God reckons it as good. We can see it. We can liberate the good that is in this moment, and we can transform it because it is laid bare before us. I believe that something of God has been liberated. Barbara Marks Hubbard once wrote, "Crisis often precedes transformation. Crisis often precedes transformation." And here we are at this critical moment. Out of the chaos, something of a higher order can be born as we reckon this moment as good. So let's call forth the good in this world by seeing the good. This lesson today is about vision, and in many ways it is a continuation of last week's lesson. And so thank you for allowing me to open my heart to you today as I pondered the experiences of this past week. But I also want to invite you, as you think about this moment in history, but also as you think about your life, I invite you to dream a bigger dream, to dream a bigger dream for our nation, but also to dream a bigger dream for your life. Cast a new vision out before you. Break free from limiting, self-defeating beliefs into a realm of possibility and potential, not only for yourself, but for our communities and for our world. We need a new national imagination, but we also need a new imagination, a new way of looking at our lives and our experience. Certainly, imagination is one of our 12 spiritual faculties, one of those attributes of the divine that is the truth of us. An old Unity book written by Florence Scovel Shinn shares that imagination is the scissors of the mind. It cuts out the shape of our lives and our experiences according to our intention and the energy of our thoughts. Our imaging faculty is that which creates vision, and our vision becomes the framework into which God pours the realization of our dreams. In Genesis, we are told that God created us in God's image and after God's likeness. And so God created us according to God's vision and endowed us with these faculties and potentialities that are part of our divine nature, that are the attributes of God's own presence, God's own spirit within us, expressing in us, through us, as us. And so we are endowed with those same creative abilities to shape our lives, to shape our common experience. And I invite you to see those possibilities, to stop being stuck in the present moment, to stop seeing this epic in which we are in as a collective family of humankind in this moment as all there is and all there will ever be, to widen the aperture of your mind and to reckon it as good. The fabric of our life, the content of our thoughts bring experience into the field of the possible. And we can either react to the experiences, as I did with my anger, to react to the experiences of our individual lives with fear and anxiety or worry, or we can be responsive to the movement of spirit within us as we seek to heal and transform our world. We can stop having tunnel vision. We can widen this narrow aperture through which we see life and our common experience together and respond with faith from a level of spiritual consciousness that broadens our horizons and sharpens our focus. I invite you to hold the vision, your dream for your life in your mind and in your heart. Love it. Give it life. Give it energy. Let go of your limiting, self-defeating beliefs and walk confidently in the direction of your dreams. We need visionaries in this world right now. Without visionaries, we cannot transform this place and time and space in which we find ourselves in this moment. We need those who can cast a bigger vision, a bigger dream out in front of them, and allow it to draw them into it. Meister Eckhart once said, "When the soul wishes to experience something, she throws an image of the experience out before her and enters into her own image." And that is the kind of visionary that we need. One that throws an image out in front of itself and enters into that vision. The divine vision for your life will cast itself out before you and pull you into it as you courageously step forward. The world needs visionaries right now. We need a new collective imagination. One that opens the aperture of our beliefs so that we flourish individually, so that we live into our divine potential, so that we say to one another, enough is enough. We will no longer act from our anger and our fear and our pain, but we will respond to the movement of spirit within us. We will be visionaries. We will live a life that flourishes, that is an expression of divine potential and possibility. We will know that for ourselves and for one another. We will know that there is more than enough for all of us. And when we do that, when we create this new vision for our life together, we can, as we are courageous enough to do so, to do the work of healing that we need to do, walk into it together. God bless you. We take a moment now in our service to open ourselves to the movement of spirit within us. through the process of giving and receiving. We invite you now to take your gift in your hand, your tithe, your offering, place it close to your heart, infuse it with the love that you most certainly are, and affirm with me our offertory statement, our prayer of abundance. Together, divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, and all that I receive. I am grateful. And truly, we know that we are so blessed. And we dedicate and consecrate these tithes, these gifts, and these offerings to the will and the work and the way of the Christ as it expresses through this ministry of love and service. Thank you, God. Amen.
Behold, the kingdom of God is within you. Not just a place to get into someday far away. Oh, be bold. It's something that you can tap into. A strength that will help you to get through each day by faith. Oh, believe the kingdom of God is at hand within each woman and man. Setting you free, the miracle in you release, receive, realize, open your eyes, behold, the kingdom of God is within you, not just a place to get into someday, far away. Something that you can tap into, a strength that can help you to get through each day by faith. Oh, behold. Somehow reach down inside you and find love that's been there all the time. Somehow, right now, somebody's broken and sad. They need you to give what you have. Right now, realize, open your eyes, behold, the kingdom of God is within you, not just a place to get into someday far away. Oh, be bold. It's something that you can tap into, a strength that will help you to get through each day by faith.
And now let us join together in singing, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every breath I take, let this be my joyful vow. To take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally.
As we affirm together the words of the prayer for protection, I invite you, as I often do, to speak these words with intention, to send them out into the very atmosphere around you so that they establish our lives, our relationships, our community, our nation, and our world in peace and light and protection and love and wisdom in the days to come. Pray with me. The light of God surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. And the presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God. Wherever I am, God is. And truly we know that all is well. And so we go from this place today, filled with an understanding that God's vision is before us, a vision of peace, a vision of light and love, a vision of hope. Go now, friends, and be the light and the peace of God in the world.